this. So for my unethical example of PR, I'm going to be using Bud Light as a case study. So basically, Bud Light is like an American brand of beer, and they had this campaign called Up For Whatever. So for this campaign, some Bud Light bottles had the message, "The perfect beer for removing no from your vocabulary for the night," printed on them, followed by "The perfect beer for whatever happens." And they basically received quite a lot of backlash because of what they were implying, which is basically, yes, it's okay, you can drink and drive, and yes, rape is okay, because no one's gonna say no. It was basically promoting the role alcohol frequently plays in rape cases, so yes, it was unethical of Bud Light. Well, this isn't a Singaporean ad per se. If we were to follow like the SCAP guidelines, it would have violated Appendix K, which deals with the advertising of alcoholic drinks. It says, advertisements should not emphasize the stimulants, sedative, or tranquilizing effects of any drink, which is basically what Bud Light did. So yeah, it's unethical. For the example of unethical journalism, I'll be using the Rolling Stone's A Rape on Campus article as my case study. So it's a really, really, really long story, but in summary, the contributing editor at the time, Sabrina Erdely, wrote an article about sexual assault on campus. And she focused on a rape case that took place in the University of Virginia, and it caused a worldwide uproar. Like, so after it was published, there were questions of like the credibility of the story, and after doing like a whole lot of investigations, it was then found out that there were indeed discrepancies in the story, and then the rape victim, Jackie, may have fabricated the story. Yeah. So the main problems in Sabrina's reporting was basically that she didn't talk to Jackie's friends who supposedly comforted her after she was assaulted, and like she didn't identify or speak to Drew, the ringleader of Jackie's attack. And there were some holes in the story, but Early didn't bother closing these gaps. And I think the worst part is that readers would never have known that she hadn't spoken to all these people who really played a crucial part in her story. So she didn't fact check, and she didn't talk to other sources, and she never questioned the information she received. So while I'm sure Sabrina had the best intentions, I believe that she was too caught up in getting the story to make sure that it was accurate. Yeah. So following SPJ's code of ethics, she failed to seek the truth and report it, and to minimize harm. I mean, Rolling Stone was sued by not only the frat members, but also by the associate dean of students for the University of Virginia. So yeah, it was a really messed up case and article. Good intentions, but yeah, unethical.